Good evening, all of you. Thank you for giving my invitation to talk on the practical aspects what we are facing. As of now, all my speakers were talking about their field. Now I'm going to talk about something which will be beneficial for each and every one of you. The reason is almost all of the patients coming to us, they are not bothered about what tablet you write, what is the medication, whether you are going to give it, what is the side effect of the tablet. No patient is going to ask you about that. One thing he asks almost every one of us is, what should I eat? But then, so unless you answer it, he is not satisfied with whatever you whatever treatment you give. So I'm going to touch upon some of the basic things which will be useful in our day-to-day practice. Like, if we are not eating properly, what happens is we become weak. So I've just looked into, if you see the literature part of it, almost all the specialities, you name the specialty, there is called malnutrition as person. One word on the malnutrition is, malnutrition means if we are losing or increasing 5% of the body weight within 1 month or 10% of the body weight within 6 months. So we are malnourished. So you can see that all the specialties, you name it, there is malnutrition person. If it is going to be hospitalized patient, almost 60% of them are malnourished. How about those patients who are coming to us, 10% are malnourished. So this is the scenario which we are facing. So what actually happens is, normally if we are going to have any disease, the first thing which happens is we don't eat properly. And what happens, we are not taking adequate food, there is protein, energy intake comes down and there is more required for the body. So what happens in this? As we grow older, we should know what is actually happening. Because I see here, most of them are about 35 and 40 years of age. So we should know what is actually happening to us in our body, physiologically. So as we grow older, what happens? There is lot of changes physiologically which is happening. Sphincter tone comes down, motility comes down. And if you are above 50, 60, emptying comes down, lands up in having constipation, all these things. So what? How does this actually happen in the nutrition aspect? You can see here, the food we take, when you were 20 years, the amount of food which you consume is almost 3000 calories. This is for the male, this is for the females. But as we grow older, you can see that the amount of calories which we take has come down drastically, and even for male and females, almost 1750 calories they take, and females they consume less than 1500 calories. So this is the ground reality which is happening. So what happens is, as we grow older, as I told you, the calories is coming down. This is one important thing which we should all understand is, when we are between 20 to 35, we have lot of muscle mass, we have less of fat. As we grow older, what is happening is, you can see here, the amount of muscle mass comes down, fat goes up. This is called sarcopenia. What happens because of that? We are actually not doing physical activity what we are supposed to do, and then there is all these things are happening. It is increased fatigue ability, muscle weakness happens, then there is endurance capacity comes down, and also muscle wasting. All this put together, reduce physical activity, we land up having all cardiometabolic diseases. So this is what we are actually having. So how to know the nutritional status? If at all we are going to see if we are having any anemia or like that, we know that we just look into our patients, that is take a blood, just check that hemoglobin, what are the numbers, we know what is the whether the patient is having anemia. So how about we can know about the nutritional status of the patient? So now let me explain you. The opposite, we can see there is a mall. When you are going to enter it, it hardly takes for you, if you are going to enter it, it will take 5 seconds for you to enter. So that is called screening. So like that, whenever a patient is going to come to us, we need to know the nutritional status of the patient within maybe 5-10 seconds. The second one, if you are going to carry any contraband substance and go in, they are not going to allow you inside, they are going to take you to a site and then do a thorough assessment, what is that you are carrying. So it might take 2 minutes or 5 minutes. So I am going to touch upon the screening part. Assessment is when you are going to get admitted in the hospital. So by looking at this patient, you know It's not that a big thing is required. The left, this person is malnourished. How about this patient? He's also malnourished. He's a fluid overload, but he's also malnourished. How to identify that? So there are a lot of tools available, but the simplest thing I'll show you is there's something called malnutrition screening tool. This is a validated tool which is being used across the world. You look into any literature, you will have this which is being used. There are only two questions which are asked. Have you lost weight recently without trying? If they say yes, these are the numbers. They say no, it is zero. Unsure, it is two. Second question, have you been eating poorly because of decreased appetite? If it is yes, it is one, no is zero. If your number is two and more, you are malnourished. Simple as that. How to do this? You know, all the patients who are coming to us, they don't walk in directly. They stay outside our clinic. We're sitting there at least for 5-10 minutes. If you are a busy practitioner, even half an hour, 1 hour. They'll just watch the TV. Instead of that, what we can do is give this paper to them. They can actually fill it, or if the nurses are good at that, they can actually fill that and give it to them so that you can see it and you will know what is the nutritional status of the patient. Now, this could be a subjective one. How can we go objectively and find out how it can be done? There is something called hand grip strength. So this is which can be used. This is called a dynamometer. You just need to put your age in this. Just you have to hold it for maximum of 2 seconds, the full strength. That's it. The numbers will be showing here, and you will know whether you are strong or you are weak. You can easily identify with this. So that the patient, whoever is telling I'm very well built and very good, also you can identify whether he is weak or normal. So this is the easiest one which can be done. Next is, there are a lot of studies also which have been done. What they have done is, when they gave a nutritional supplement along with this, when they found out the week and they gave a nutritional supplement, what happens by 2 months, they found out that the patient's weight was actually, the hand grip strength actually improved. So that means the patient's having gaining strength. Before he was weak and he was not able to do his normal activity also. So now let's see a case where nowadays we see a lot of dengue and other things happening. Say a 40-year-old female patient present with symptoms of dry cough, running nose, body ache, she has fever, fatigue, loss of appetite. She has fever for 4 days, temperature was 103, pulse 106, weight and height of the patient. The diagnosis was acute respiratory tract infection we were treating. And sometimes we have a differential diagnosis, might could be also dengue also nowadays. So in that case, what actually happens? We should know the physiological part, what is happening. Always remember, whenever there is a fever which is settled, almost 200 to 50 or 500 grams of muscle is being utilized for the patient. And this is a very important one. When there is a 1 degree Fahrenheit increase, 7% increase of BMR happens. If there is 1 degree Celsius rise in body temperature, 13% increase in BMR happens. This happens for all. So we should know this at the back of the mind. And in this patients, what happens? If you are going to eat 3 idlis, the day where you are having fever, you will end up on having eating half or 1 idli. So there is the amount of calories you take is less, infection is there, it is a vicious cycle which is actually happening. And this slide you can see, if you're going to have a typhoid fever, the amount of nitrogen he is losing is almost 87 grams. Severe typhoid, 186 grams. Like you fever, other. So every thing you have a decrease of nitrogen which is happening in our body. Another important thing is, what are the drugs which we prescribe? Now, we are not taught about what are the problems which a patient is going to have when he is going to be prescribed with drugs. I just touch upon some simple drugs which we use day in and day out, like Brufen or other drugs, we give it for pain. There is folic acid loss happens. If you are going to give aspirin, folic acid, vitamin C, potassium, zinc losses happens. Antacids, all these vitamin D, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus losses happens. How about H2 inhibitors, folic acid, B12, vitamin D. I am not put the high end like proton pump inhibitors. You can see here even amoxicillin, penicillin, all the B complex with biotin, inositol losses. And nowadays we write erythromycin, azithromycin, here also lot of losses happens. We have to keep this at the back of our mind whenever we are writing any prescription. Not just writing a B complex, the patient is going to get all the vitamins back to him because of the bioavailability parameter. So I have not put all the topmost antibiotic like third generation, fourth generation. This is a basic pills. So we expect all this from our food. But when I just saw the plate where everybody were having just before this, it was totally of carbohydrates, you would have seen. So what happens because of that is, like, do you ask any patient, they'll tell, I'm eating very well. We just have a photo of it and we just wanted to see. This is how we give it. And we ask a patient, I ate only. But you would have seen, check it, you would have left all this. But for him, he has finished the total food. So this is the practical thing which is happening for a patient when he is having a fever or any infection. So how to manage these patients? Remember, we know how to treat the infection. We are well versed in it, we know the best antibiotic, we do everything. But one thing which we lack is this one, nutrition. How to compensate that? So what is the first primary challenge we have is to make sure that negative nitrogen balance we are answering. The second one is negative energy balance. So these two things we have to correct for any patient who's going to come. How to do it? The negative nitrogen balance with the help of protein and the negative energy balance by carbohydrate and fat. So we have to make sure that we are doing a complete protein, fat and calorie nutrition. That's a very important one. The reason is many of the patients now have gone into all popular diets like paleo and all other diets. They don't take this part at all, carbohydrate, zero carbohydrate. Some of the ladies have seen that, those who are in the colleges, what they do is they don't take fat, zero fat. So you land up in having some nutrition problem, which is going to be that we have to make sure we are taking a complete and balanced nutrition. So that is the most important. How to do it? We have to make sure that we are taking protein, which is available in all these things, and carbohydrates and fats, which is also present. We know that we have to take a lot of vegetables and fruits also. But because of the cost, even tomato is going up more than 100, so you cannot expect them to take even a salad part of it. I'm telling you ground reality. But we have to make sure we are giving a complete and balanced nutrition for the patient. So when we are going to give a complete and balanced, the patient, we are not thinking of just treating the patient. We are vaccinating the children like that. We have to have a prophylaxis so that once we give a complete and balanced nutrition, the patient's immunity goes up. So the chances of infection also comes down for the patient. So just to conclude, we know that as malnutrition is present for all the patients, we have to make sure that we are giving a complete and balance so that we can bring down the hospital stay if it's going to be the hospital, and if they are going to come to us, the oral nutrition therapy has to be given, macro and micronutrients, so that we are actually giving the patients the benefit, so that he is actually preventing him from having all the infection. We are improving the immunity. Thank you. Any questions, sir?
One issue.
Yes, sir.
Protein.
Fat.